In a year full of surprises, here are Metal Injection's top 20 news stories of 2022. Axl Rose apparently spent a lot of money on the Use Your Illusion album art, not knowing he could have had it for free. According to manager Axel Niven, Axl Rose paid artist Mark Castabbi $75,000 for the use of his artwork on the covers of the Use Your Illusion albums, as well as merchandise, not knowing the images were public domain and evidently could have been used for free. Vinnie Paul's house has been demolished. Pantera and Hell Yeah drummer Vinnie Paul's former home in Arlington, Texas, hit the market for $750,000 in February. The house sold pretty quickly to an anonymous buyer, and that was that. Unfortunately, according to former Ride for Dime charity event promoter Derek D-Rock Walker, the house has been demolished. In a Facebook post, Walker lamented the destruction of the house and posted some of the photos of the now empty lot and claimed that the home was sold to private investors for a new build. Bruce Dickinson blasted fans smoking weed at a recent Iron Maiden show. During the band's show on September 22nd in Anaheim, California, a fan got on stage for way too long before getting tossed by vocalist Bruce Dickinson. Footage surfaced of Dickinson taking some fans to task for smoking weed in the front row the night before. During the break between one of the songs, Dickinson gave fans a stern talking to about their smoking habits, saying it's affecting both him and bassist Steve Harris. In a conversation with Interview magazine, Korn singer Jonathan Davis discussed the new generation of artists, saying, "I'm totally into talent. It seems like music has moved on to a place where it doesn't matter about talent. It's about how talented the engineer is at faking everything." Fan rushes Rage Against the Machine on stage. Security takes out Tom Morello instead. At a Rage Against the Machine show in Toronto on July 23rd, some fan got on stage and ran from the side to the front before jumping off and trying to escape into the crowd. Security went to tackle the guy, either tripped or got juked by the fan, and took out guitarist Tom Morello instead. Polyphia played the May 27th date of the So What Music Festival, and things went a little rockier than they may have looked to the audience. According to a video posted by Belmont guitarist Jason Tyler, Polyphia drummer Clay Aishleman's in-ear monitors failed sometime during the band's set. This meant that Aishleman couldn't hear his Polyphia bandmates at all or have any sort of metronome to keep himself in time. Fortunately, his drum tech Chris Lent came over to tap out the tempo on his leg, and of course, it helps that Clay knew the music by heart. Foo Fighters released a thrashy death metal song. Foo Fighters released their new horror comedy, Studio 66, on February 25th. In the movie, the fictional death metal group Dream Widow, featuring Grohl and Company, released a new song called March of the Insane. Frankly, the song kicked a very real amount of ass and may now cause fans to hound Grohl about when we're getting more Dream Widow. Slash names what he considers to be the heaviest riff of all time. Guns N' Roses guitarist Slash recently spoke to Matt Pinfield about the impact Black Sabbath had on his life, and the incredible waves the band's debut album has had over the years. Slash talked about his love of Black Sabbath's 1973 album, Sabbath Bloody Sabbath, adding that the title track has probably the heaviest riff of all time. The time Peter Steele got into a bar fight with Deftones vocalist Chino Marino. In an episode of the podcast Change in the House of Pods, Darren Eggleston, a former radio promotions associate, recalls a time in 1996 when Type O Negative frontman, the late Peter Steele, angered by some of Marino's antics earlier in the day, tried to punch the Deftones singer in a hotel bar immediately afterward. Earlier that day, Marino had invited fans on stage, and someone had lit one of the curtains on fire. Because of the fire, Type O Negative never went on and they were pissed. The frontman then punched Chino in the bar afterwards. Kerry King confirmed partial lineup for his new band, says new music is coming soon. Slayer guitarist Kerry King has been talking about his mysterious new band ever since the dissolution of Slayer in 2019. The rumor was that the band consisted of King's Slayer bandmates, guitarist Gary Holt and drummer Paul Bostaph, as well as Pantera vocalist Phil Anselmo. We now know one of those things to be true, as King has confirmed to Metal Hammer that the new band does indeed feature Paul Bostaph. Judas Priest Rob Halford offered his opinion on Spotify's recent issues. Spotify found itself in the limelight due to Neil Young and several other artists pulling their music from the platform. Judas Priest vocalist Rob Halford weighed in with his opinion on the matter, essentially saying that Neil Young did what was right for him, and that's all there is to it. Halford added he doesn't see Judas Priest disappearing from the platform either, and prefers to keep his music and politics separate. Nickelback was just kidding this whole time. In an interview with WRIF, Nickelback frontman Chad Kroeger said the band's hits were written very tongue-in-cheek and weren't meant to be taken seriously. And then everyone did, and Nickelback became huge. Which is actually pretty great if you think about it. You're goofing off with your friends one minute, and the next minute you're international superstars. Not bad. Sharon Osbourne makes her feelings about Bruce Dickinson super clear. In an interview with Consequence, Sharon called Dickinson a asshole because calling him a prick isn't fair, as a prick's nice. Sharon later clarifies that she doesn't have a problem with Iron Maiden as a band and closes by saying, Ozzy is original and Bruce isn't, and that's what eats Bruce away. Black Label Society guitarist Zakk Wylde and Anthrax drummer Charlie Benanti have joined the reunited Pantera for their coming 2023 tour. According to Billboard, the tour and addition of both Wylde and Benanti have been greenlit by the estates of Pantera guitarist Dimebag Darrell and drummer Vinnie Paul. This was especially interesting given that Rex Brown has said in the past that Wylde will not be a part of things, despite his comments over the years that he'd love to do it. Backing tracks at live shows causes a stir after Falling in Reverse cancels their show due to missing laptops. Falling in Reverse was supposed to play the Will Rock Festival on September 24th, but canceled the night prior thanks to the missing laptops. Will Rock, I regret to inform you that we have to cancel, said vocalist Ronnie Radke in a TikTok video. Of course, the reaction from fans was mixed, with some being understanding and others voicing opinions like, if you need a laptop to perform, you're not a band. Kiss guitarist Paul Stanley revealed who he thinks are the best lead singers of all time. Stanley's picks are all pretty much classic rock, but there's also a reason they made it into the pantheon of classic rock. They're pretty damn good. The list goes as follows: Ann Wilson, Brian Johnson, Brad Delp, Steve Perry, Janis Joplin, Paul Rogers, Rod Stewart, David Ruffin, Freddie Mercury, Steve Marriott, and at number one, Robert Plant. Jim Root explained why he didn't contribute much to Slipknot's new album. Guitarist Jim Root has played a pretty major role in Slipknot's music over the years, but found himself on the sidelines during the writing of The End so far. In an interview with Guitar World, Root credits bassist Alessandro Venturella and percussionist M. Sean Crayon for picking up his slack during the album's writing sessions. Root then opened up about a severe depression during the pandemic, saying the idea of writing music or playing guitar was just too depressing. Kiss is currently out on the road for their End of the Road Farewell Tour, which is scheduled to wrap up sometime in 2023. In an interview with Let There Be Talk podcast, bassist and vocalist Gene Simmons said the tour might not end in New York, and that Kiss will continue in other ways, saying Kiss the touring band will stop, but the touring band, Kiss will continue in other ways. I have no problems with four deserving 20-year-olds sticking the makeup back on and hiding their identity. Simmons then elaborated on how Kiss might continue in the future, saying there could be future tours where it's different lineups around the world. Meshuggah has plenty of excellent songs throughout their entire career, though arguably their biggest hit is Bleed from the 2008 Obzen record. In a recent interview with Metal Injection, Thomas Hockey said the one song that gets the most people into Meshuggah is Bleed, also saying, on a personal level, I mean, obviously I wish I never had to play Bleed once in my life, but here we are, we have to do it. Maynard James Keenan recently spoke with Rick Beato on his YouTube channel for an hour-long conversation, touching on all of Keenan's projects. When discussing Tool's writing process, Keenan summarized that listening to each other and working by committee is the best recipe for success, at least for Tool anyway. Asked if he has final say in the group, he firmly stated no, it has to be by committee. Even if it's f***ing death by committee. It has to be by committee because you have to trust each other at the end of the day for it to be the full encompassing piece with several sets of eyes and ears on it.